Many times on this journey, along the Pacific Crest from Mexico to Canada, people asked, "What inspired you?" My short answer was always, to deal with a midlife crisis. I would also explain to some that my career was in a rut. There were also deaths in my family, and my parents were slipping. I began to question the meaning of it all. To quote Carrie Temple, "Somewhere in the backstretch of life, the race was lost, the purpose covered over." It was time to find redemption. It was time to go outside and walk. Sandy hiked with me for the first week.
Here we are at the Puerto Allen camp. A little visit to Mexico. We can't afford a ticket, but we can always dream. It looks so good, you could almost kiss the screen. We've seen the bloom, we've seen the smile. Get a map and count the miles. Okay, we're coming over the last pass before descending to Lake Morena, and that dropped down and back up through little, what was the name of it? Hauser Creek Valley. And it was a grind, but hot, yes, very sun exposed, but beautiful scenery as we came out of that valley. All the way in California. So here we are, 7:41, pulling into Morena Village near Lake Morena, and it says the campground's closed for herbicide application, but we're going to get here to the malt shop for a little food, and then we're going to figure out what to do with camping. If you feel like a river lost in the deep blue
sea. Leftover pizza from yesterday.
It's pretty good looking pie. That's Kitchen Creek down there. We're going down to do some cooking. Awesome. Yeah. When we get there, what will we find?
Will we find something? We'll have been. Plus two is what?
Three?
Wrong.
Oh.
What is the cube root of 2,197?
13?
Right!
Ding, smart ding, ding. Water does it every time.
From Julian, we got a ride that would take me back to the trail and Sandy to the airport. I gave Sandy a hug and a kiss and told her I loved her. And I started north.
Just got done with the Julian resupply and leaving Sandy to go back to the airport. And I'm just walking away from Scissors Crossing. At the end of the day, but about an hour and a half to a water tank someplace called Mary's. Got the heart rate up for sure.
Oh my.
Feet from here to there, and the trail takes me there in 23 miles. And he rattled and kind of curled his head back. So I tried to go up on the hillside. Of course, the rocks I was stepping on broke loose. Had a little more spice to the adventure. I don't know if it was a hornet's nest or what, but man, one just got me on the cheek. I ran for 100 yards before shaking, swatting with my hanky. Whew. Thank you. There was Deep Creek Hot Springs, which is just a great ending to a crescendo of 10 miles of hiking in this canyon, and clothing optional. And I'd say maybe six or eight people there when I got there, and clothing was optional, that's for sure. This is a spillway for the dam. Supposed to be good echo out here. Woo! Echo!
Three Points Trailhead, 31 miles of the PCT that I had to skip. It's got a trail closure. And Carol, she's a trail angel who stocks up coolers with snacks and cold sodas and water. Here she is driving an hour here to drop me off, and has got an hour drive back to hit a 10 o'clock meeting this morning. Just leaving Acton, KOA, and everybody's talking about the heat. It's 11 a.m. and I'm showing just shy of 110 degrees out here. I think there's a couple miles. There's an underpass under the highway, which should be cool. Oh wow, does this feel good. I bet it's dropped 30 degrees in this tunnel from outside. Here's the little town of Agua Dulce. Going to Maria Bonita's Mexican restaurant here.
Do a little night hiking. Hopefully beat the heat somewhat.
Push it past the dust.
It is hot. Expected high today, 108 to 113. And all I gotta say is this umbrella is a lifesaver. Finally dropping into the Mojave Desert. I'm a little anxious about it because the heat has been oppressive. But here, 4:30 finally rolling, and trying to get this stretch across the desert squared away here before it gets hot again. I guess it's going to be into the hundreds easily again today. It's a little warm out here this morning, but a nice breeze and the sun's starting to come up, so here we go. Could I give you a ice cold Coors Light? So here comes the truck up the road, guy and his dog, and he said, "You look like you could use an ice cold seltzer. I'm being overserved out here in the desert." Apparently, thought I needed a second. Cheers, my friend. That was awful nice of you. Thank you. Last night, hitching into Tehachapi, third or fourth car that came by stopped, and he said, "Oh yeah, I see PCT hikers. I like to pick you up whenever I can because you're doing something awesome." Met with some other hikers at a Chinese buffet. One of the wait staff came over and said, "You might want to thank that gentleman over there. He just picked up the tab for all of you." And then at the grocery store, person at the checkout looked me straight in the eye and she said, "You be careful out there. It's very remote and almost never around people, but when you're around people, it's so clear. They're hugging you the whole way." And my amazing wife, Sandy, she's encouraged me to do this and has supported me the whole way. And everybody's asking her where I'm at, how I'm doing, what's going on. It's like I feel like there's a crowd cheering me on. Not only water, but provides all the hand washing to help minimize infection risk. Box full of battery banks, guidebook, and then a little first aid kit here. It's amazing, this little trickle is life-sustaining. I just came across a guy in heat exhaustion, like walk a mile and vomit, walk a mile and vomit. That's a serious thing, it could be lethal. Nice guy, what a shame, man. This is the best rest spot. Doing a downhill run, the last downhill, 2,500 feet down, and then about 8 miles of rolling terrain to Kennedy Meadows. But with any luck, I can get there tonight to Grumpy's, maybe have dinner, because I am officially out of food. Close. Well.
I found two beers and a small bag of almonds to have for dinner that night, and then went to bed.
Walking away from Grumpy Bear's retreat in Kennedy Meadows, and I'm actually feeling uncertainty about whether I'm gonna actually finish this trip. Sad, I feel sad right now. All right, that was totally awesome. Right when I needed a boost in the morale. Car coming up the road, and it's Jake. He says, "Hop in." Got me back to the trail. Official first rain of the trip, and it happens to be day one after the desert. Anyway, this is cool. It's happiness. This perpetual solitude has been really hard. Since Cottonwood Pass, boom, hiker traffic has picked up enormously. It's been a pleasure just to talk to people. Maybe I'll survive the solitude. All right, it's 5:40 in the morning. We got climbing Mount Whitney this morning. It was a wet setup in camp last night with some rain, and everything's soaking wet this morning. So. And the temperature is 30 or 32 degrees, so it's pretty chilly.
Regret, remorse, hold on, no, I gotta go. race is on. Just gotta keep on keeping on. Gotta keep on going, looking straight out on the road. Can't worry about what's behind you, what's coming for you further up the road. Try not to hold on to what is gone. I try to do right what is wrong. I try to keep on keeping on. Yeah, I just keep on keeping on. I hear a voice call, calling out for me. These shackles I made in a town to be free. Be it for ease, be it for love, I won't take the easy road. Ooh, 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 ooh. Oh. Ooh, ooh. I've woken up in a hotel room. My worries as big as the moon. Having no idea what or where I am. Something good comes with the bad. A song's never just sad. There's hope, there's a silver light. Show me my silver light. Show me my silver light. I hear a voice call, calling out for me. These shackles I made in the town to be free.
probably about halfway through a 300-mile section where bear canisters are required. Unfortunately, canister doesn't hold much food. So since last resupply, been a little skimpy. Typical daily food ration is, well, I got one box of cold cereal that is divided up into five portions. Typically, lunch is a one pack of ramen noodles, and dinner is a package of stovetop stuffing for snack, a granola bar, and a pack of peanuts, and that's it. Getting a little skinny here. Well, it was super cool seeing Beth and Robert out here, and they so nice. They brought food and extra supplies, and we had wine and everything else. Just awesome. Meeting them in the middle of Yosemite after almost 2 months now of not seeing a single person I know. It was wonderful to have a visit with family. Touching, to say the least.
As a naive Midwesterner, I didn't expect that my life on the trail might revolve around fires. In Northern California, many miles of trail closed within hours or days of my approach.
We begin this evening on the Fire Watch, a lightning spark tamarack fire exploding overnight. Tamarack fire is now 15,000 acres. That is up from 6,600 acres this morning. It was only 500 acres yesterday.
75 miles of the trail is closed. So we had to do a workaround, van ride to Bridgeport, caught a bus from Bridgeport to Carson City, Nevada. And Carson City, Nevada, we were gonna Uber, but a couple said, we got a pickup truck, why don't we just take you up there? So they drove us an hour out of their way to get us to the trail. So here we are. On top of Tinker Knob, and here's an easy chair. This is hilarious. Hey! How many beers have you had?
None! I've been waiting for you!
So this permanent gets a big beer.
Oh yeah, 340s.
Oh my gosh, that's awesome.
Ew.
Thank you.
A growing threat as the giant Dixie Fire carves a destructive path, now the largest single wildfire in California history.
Really ever die, no one really ever dies. Oh, sweet, oh, oblivion, dear child.
It's cold and rainy.
And wild, got to get it.
And sun and clouds and rumbles of thunder. It's beautiful. Loving this umbrella still. Not just for sunshine. There's no car to go back to at the end of the day, no house to walk into, and I'm stuck with everything soaked if I don't be careful right now. Oh yeah, let's throw in a little hail. Two or three fires near the road to Etna. Another lightning storm going right now. But lightning was evidently what started that fire. There's one road between here and the road to Etna. And I'm gonna try to get to that and hopefully be able to learn more in the morning. Certainly don't want to go toward them if they're active at all, and that's likely to be the case. In the meantime, dealing with another storm right now. Woohoo!
Nobody wanna give my heart away. You can make your mind up. We can take your time. I hope it seems you've mistaken me for someone who cares. I'm just a dirtbag under the weather. And overrated seems you've mistaken me for someone who cares. I'm just a dirtbag.
On the Fire Watch tonight. The river complex is continuing to grow, now more than 185,000 acres with 30% containment.
Making money not knowing what it means. I'm a liar. Set shit on fire. Take your time talking down to all your friends. Living with the little dogs and elephants. It's hard to find it, but I don't mind it. It seems you're mistaken. Dirtbag under the weather. An overrated scene. You've mistaken me for someone who cares.
joint that's been sore at the base of my pinky, the head of the metatarsal. Like every footstep hurts. I'm gonna try moleskin, start cutting the shoes if I need to. Into the day, and I have more energy than I've had all day. And there's something totally awesome about walking into the dark on a mountain in the smoke in a place I've never been. It is so freaky out here, but it makes you feel alive, and I'm loving it.
It was a good hike last night.
Dehydrated because I just haven't had enough water, and the water I had was terrible. So I guess lesson learned, this is probably the third time on this whole trip where I've ended up in pretty serious dehydration conditions. In the morning or 4:45, we're going up to Watchman's Overlook, fire lookout, to watch the sun come up from the east. Jumping into a caldera.
Thank you.
huckleberries.
There's the South Sister, which I was hoping to hitchhike to get to the trailhead to hike up, but no luck. And there's no question, a single middle-aged male is not a good target for picking up in a hitchhike. So I'm walking up the road 5 miles to the trailhead, and then I'll do the hike, hopefully. Light rain or drizzle, heavy drizzle, light rain, and it's 40 degrees or a little lower. Phone call from hospice. My dad's been in hospice, and she's pretty sure he's gonna die real soon.
It is probably not gonna live past the end of the day, so I'm pulling the plug on this trip, and it's hard to get out of here, but that's okay. I'll get there. I didn't envision this ending this way, and again, nothing on the PCT is anything we forecast. No matter how you plan things, there's curves in the road and it doesn't go as planned. And this is just one more of those things.
I'll be coming home soon. Cause like the enemies that we are battling, I am nothing but a human alien. I left with nothing else but to keep wandering down this path while stopping my hands trembling. Because I know that I'll be coming home soon. And yes, I know that I'll be coming home soon. With a soldier's eye, with a soldier's eye.
I should have counted how many cars.
With a soldier's eyes, I've seen inside the devil's dreams where young men die. And graveyards open up their arms for mothers left to cry. I have seen the bleeding, and I hear what we've done. But just like every other fool here, I'll keep marching on. Because I know that I'll be coming home soon.
My dad was unconscious, and the only hope for him was that he'd be comfortable as he died. But somehow he rallied, came back to consciousness, and stabilized. I walked in the door to his warm greeting and broke down in tears. Family and friends encouraged me to finish the trail. My dad gave me the nod. Following my adventure gave him zest for life.
Back into the wild. It's awesome. I flew to Seattle, took a shuttle bus to Burlington, got a lift, LYFT, out here to the trailhead. Heading up the East Bank Trail, gonna pick up the Pacific Northwest Trail, and in about 40 or 50 miles, plan to be at the north terminus of the PCT, where I'll officially start the final section going south.
All around, I'm face to face with myself as I keep looking down. Hard to step into place I never knew. Knock me down.
It's funny, to get back up on the ridge, you forget Pacific Crest is on a crest, and it's going up a little over 5,000 feet in 6 miles. Pretty long and steep. Full food and full water right now, so kind of heavy on this climb.
Holding on to black and white, I'm gray. There are bigger mountains, life's too much.
Canada.
It's been really exciting to see people heading back from the terminus. They finished the PCT, can't exit through Canada because of COVID restrictions, so they all have to turn around and go back 30 miles or so, and it's been really cool. Give them a little fist bump along the way, tell them congratulations. While I'm not celebrating with others here in my completion of the PCT, I'm celebrating a new start, 600 mile southbound journey, and man, does it feel good. On a bunch of bushes and then look back at me. Just sort of took off lumbering up the trail. I've not seen that big a bear up close out in the wild, so cool deal. Holding on to black and white, I'm gray. There are bigger mountains, life's tomorrow. Standing here with that rain. Dear you, whether you are just starting on this journey or finishing, you deserve a pat on the back. I could sit and wax poetic with a bunch of cliches, but who has the time? This journey will break you open. It will shine light in your darkest corners. It'll slap you across the face and kiss you on the mouth. Have gratitude for yourself, for your fellow wanderers, for the trail, for she is a living, breathing thing. Make yourself at home. Stop for a moment to look up. You're doing the thing that most people dream of. You're living. Take good, sweet care. I love you. Songbird, class of 2018. Monster with teeth. Holy crap, that was a 20 mile climb. It took 7.5 hours, 4,500 feet of vert. found a string cheese package. Yum. Trail candy. Really foggy and drizzling and it's cold, but I'm hoping to hike out of it. There's probably some awesome scenery around here, but it's not gonna happen for me today, and that's all right, because look what I found. There it is, the toilet. It was getting thicker, foggier, drizzlier, light rain, windier, and there's only an hour of daylight. It was a tough one. It was getting tough, getting gnarly out there. Cooking dinner under the rain fly in the rain. Ended up descending into that gorgeous cloud layer I was admiring. And hopefully, now going uphill again, with any luck, maybe climb out of the cloud again. Let's see. Slide of the hand. Never seen. You wanna dance, you don't know how to get it on. Weather is chasing me. Your eyes just fall in line. Time. Yay. Tepid coffee. It's not iced coffee. It's not hot coffee, but it's damn tasty. It's coffee time. You guys are awesome. It's one log at a time, but it's 2,600 miles of trail. I wish I could offer you a beer.
Get it on the floor and don't hold back for anyone, close your eyes.
summit in and Snoqualmie Pass, and there's a forecast for lots of rain for the next few days, so I'm actually waiting it out for a bit. There it is, the standard dinner for a thru-hiker. Can't sit here forever. This rain system is kind of crazy, but it's the last day of rain. Supposedly it's going to be better tomorrow, and I've been in here for 2 days kind of trying to wait it out. Time to get going. It'll get wet today. But here it goes. Like a little family of them with their hats on, their rain hats.
Okay, it poured rain all night.
I got to put on wet rain gear this morning, but I have some hot coffee going right now. It's going to be a wet mess to pack up, and it's going to be heavy because everything's kind of wet, but I'll get to dry it out, and it looks like a nice long run of nice weather coming, so it's not all bad. It's good. Getting an early start. The elk were still howling their mating call. Still are, actually, which is kind of haunting in the dark walking through the woods. It's shaping up to be a nice sunrise. Your time and be careful. Holy crap, am I glad to see this trail. It's getting late.
Have a good time, there's nothing I
harsher today just to avoid rain that's supposed to be coming in 2 days of rain forecasted. So hopefully I can get as many miles in as possible before that shows up.
Grape nuts with carnation instant breakfast chocolate flavored. I set up dry last night, but started raining right after that. It's been raining all night. It's gonna rain all day today, all night tonight, and all day tomorrow.
Keeping everything dry is really problematic, and if the temperatures are in the 40s as they've been, it becomes difficult to know how you're gonna fare in it when your gear gets all wet. Thank goodness this is only a 2 day run of it. So far so good, I'm making it. That was really tough. Hiked 22 miles, really, really heavy downpour. Somehow managed to get the tent set up. Everything that I need in the tent, and I'm all dry and warm in here. It's pretty good. It's kind of an Asian vibe to it. I'll give it a thumbs up. But yesterday, trying to get some water underneath that bridge, I was trying to get under the little footbridge, and in doing so was stepping down these big, nice, smooth, wet rocks that were very slippery as it turned out, and I took a spill. It's like, oh, there's a little surprise. There's a backpack trying to push me face down into the water. It's really clumsy and it hurt. It's pretty sore to use that, and I smacked my knee pretty good too. That's all part of the adventure, I guess.
The PCT will not let you down. It will challenge you. PCT!
I came to this place as a visitor, a guest, a sojourner. I had been a traveler passing through, having come to this place in the wild, knowing it to be a temporary existence, knowing that the moment would come when I have to move on from here. Now comes the after. I received word that my dad was again in a downward spiral. I arrived home to find him unresponsive. Hoping he could hear, I told him I finished. I hugged him and told him I loved him, that it was okay for him to let go. My mom, siblings, and my wife did the same. He died later that night. The compounded emotions from losing my dad and finishing the PCT have been incomprehensible. But this is life, the cycles of time, the rhythms of seasons, of life and light and death. It is best to find one's place in the natural order of things under the stars, amid the flowers and the ferns, the ancient rocks, and the water that never stops, and to understand the frailty of flesh and bone. The world is a mean, mysterious, and wonderful place.